In February, my period was a little late. I've always had a very normal cycle. And just when I thought, okay, maybe I should buy a pregnancy test, my period came. So after that, I thought nothing more of it because all of my periods were normal.
A few weeks later, her best friend Samantha noticed a change in Kaitlyn's appetite.
Kaitlyn started eating more and we would constantly eat all day long.
From June on, it was almost like she was eating all the time.
Oh! I was amazed at how much food she ate. It was a lot.
In July, I went to put a swimsuit on, and when I looked at myself in the mirror, I thought I'd probably put on about 30 pounds. I didn't go out and buy new clothes. I just stuck to wearing t-shirts. I thought maybe the weight gain was because I started working at an Italian restaurant. I was eating pizza and pasta. I never picked a salad off of the menu.
But Samantha came up with an alternative.
Okay, I'm not trying to be rude, but...
I was like, I don't want to hurt your feelings, but are you pregnant?
No. I'm on my period right now.
Okay. And she was like, no, I'm not pregnant, I'm just fat.
Let's go.
Okay.
Other than gaining the extra weight, Kaitlyn didn't detect anything unusual. 2 months later, Kaitlyn was suddenly awoken by intense pains in her stomach.
About 2:30 in the morning, I started getting really bad cramps. It was time for my period, and so I got up to use the restroom, and I noticed a little blood. When I laid back down, I noticed another cramp. And this time, it was probably 5 times worse than it was the first time.
I could tell that she was really hurting, and I tried to get her to go to the hospital, but she wouldn't go.
I told Jason it was just a really bad period, and I just wanted to wait it out and see how I felt by the morning. Around 4 a.m., I went and got into the spare bedroom bed so that I wouldn't wake him up anymore. An hour later, it felt like someone had a knife inside of me and was twisting it. Every 2 minutes, it was the same pain.
In the morning when I got up, I tried to get her to go to the hospital again, and she wouldn't go.
After Jason left and I was alone, I decided that maybe a hot bath would ease the pain a little bit. My pain was a 10 on a scale of 1 to 10. Every time I moved, it just felt like someone was stabbing me with another knife. And I knew something was really wrong. I felt the need to push, and I'm asking myself, what are you pushing out? I reached down. I felt something really slimy. I immediately thought my body was pushing my own organs out. There was no way that I could have gotten out of the bathtub to call for help. I could have screamed as loud as I could and no one would have heard me. I was terrified. I thought I was gonna die in my bathtub. And then I reached down again and I felt the hair. This is when I knew that I was about to deliver a baby. I started hysterically crying because I was all alone. I was holding onto the sides of the bathtub and I was pushing. About 5 minutes later, he just came right out. I grabbed him from up out of the water. I knew that this child depended on me. So I think mother instincts just kicked in. I've seen babies delivered on TV and I've watched pretty much everything that they do. And I stuck my finger into his mouth to get anything out that could have been in there. He was very small, so I began to get nervous. I got a towel and I wrapped him up. And when I did that, he cried. And when we got out of the bathroom, I grabbed a pair of scissors and I took a lighter and I burnt them to try to sterilize him. And I cut his umbilical cord.
When you cut an umbilical cord, you want to clamp off the baby side and clamp off the maternal side and then cut in between. If you don't clamp off the cut, the baby could lose some blood and become anemic.
I saw a text message from Samantha.
Hey, what's up?
I just just had a baby in the bathtub.
What? No, you didn't.
I didn't know if she was joking or, you know, I had a baby in the bathtub. Who would believe that?
She said, no, you didn't. And she heard the baby cry.
And my heart just stopped.
I heard the phone fall, and then she picked it back up and told me, I'm gonna call 911, you need to call 911. And then we both hung up. And then I called 911.
Sheriff's office.
I had a baby in my bathtub. Somebody's there to take me to the hospital.
Okay. How many months pregnant were you?
I didn't know I was pregnant.
When the ambulance arrived, they put a hat on his head, wrapped him up in another blanket, and then after examining me, making sure everything was okay,
all right, Kaitlyn,
we headed to the hospital.
While out with his mother, Kaitlyn's boyfriend Jason was called by the paramedics and told that she'd just had a baby.
Oh my gosh.
It was just like instant, you know, terror and shock. Was she all right? Was the baby alive?
I thought we just have to get to the hospital now, okay?
Just all the worst things in the world ran through my head all at once.
He told me she had a baby in the bathtub. I was just in total shock.
We took off towards the hospital and ran about 90, 95 the whole way.
When Jason arrived at the hospital 10 minutes later, the paramedics were still removing Kaitlyn from the ambulance.
Her face was just total shock, and you could just tell she was terrified.
I was worried that the baby wasn't fully developed and something was wrong with the baby. The doctors were working on him, taking blood samples and checking his heart.
The baby was about 5 weeks early. He was small, he was 4 pounds, 8 ounces.
Term pregnancy is considered to be 37 weeks, and the further away you are from that point, the higher your risks are. Risks of prematurity include things like respiratory distress syndrome, which is a problem with the lungs, a problem with the blood vessels in the baby's eyes that can cause blindness.
We're in good shape.
His lungs were developed, his heart was fine, his brain was functioning correctly. I was just happy that he was okay.
They named the baby Jason Grant Jr.
When I first held the baby, I immediately felt connected to him.
I would never imagine my best friend having a baby and not knowing she was pregnant.